Howdy folks, and welcome back. Let's play Drakensang, the River of Time, and every time I say that, I am immediately wanting to say the Dark Eye, which this is not. This is the sequel. Prequel. You know what I'm talking about.
You so, there. Oh. In the name of the River Father, stop!
What's up? You wish? What may I ask? May I ask what you want?
River Father and his voice observe all things that take place on the river. Use caution in your deeds and plans. We will be observing you.
Is that a threat? I'm not sure what you're trying to tell me, but thank you for your advice anyway.
By the thunderboxes, Emerin, stop pestering travelers with your blathering.
Day in and day out, you let your burdens be carried on his back. Therefore, you should pay homage to him and honor him.
I've had enough of you. Get out of here now and leave the people in peace.
Well, just a moment. I want to hear what he has to say.
And you, keep your nose out of my business, if you please. That fellow isn't welcome here.
There is more to lose here than mortals could ever know. So beware of the dark tentacles. Otherwise, death and destruction will befall you. But you are also the protector of hope and power. One seam in the fabric of life. Find me on the Isle of Forgetting, which is now marked on your map. It is there that destiny is to be fulfilled.
Enough, you stinking piece of flotsam. Leave this place right now and take your raft with you. You have blocked my jetty long enough today.
You may be the master of the harbor here, but you aren't lord of the river. Nevertheless, I'll do what you ask. However, only until next time. Farewell, Albert.
Okay. So we have unlocked a new location on our map, the Isle of Forgetting. Can I just bring that up at any time? Nadoret and its environs, we cannot zoom out. Right-click function on your mouse to add or delete. Oh, we can actually leave notes. That's incredibly handy. Let's see, main menu, message log, quest book, character sheet. All right, we do have a world map. All right, here we go. So the Isle of Forgetting is down here, which I don't think there is no fast travel. We have to find, a transition area on the map. One of the big things about this game that I heard talked about quite favorably is that in the first one, shoddy chest, oh, we're going for that. In the first one, you would hit points in the game where you would be locked out of going back to other areas. And from what I understand, in this one, there is none of that. So you can pretty much always go back to areas that you've been in, which I like because that gives you the ability to, you know, get into an area and you're not necessarily ready for it. So you come back later when you are. Whereas in the first one, there were a couple points where I felt like if I had had the chance maybe to explore more, I would have kind of gone back and done some stuff. I don't like this guy. Orbermaster Orbert's kind of a dick. A Balunk rider and an inconspicuous man.
Oh my god.
I'm in Nadoret to complete my training. My name is Devon.
Oh, nice for you. Then you could disappear from my harbor now.
One of these days I might learn how to disappear before your eyes, but until then, perhaps you can tell me where I can find Master Brookbeard.
Who else? It had to be Brookbeard. The way you're chattering. Ask the guard at the town's north gate. He's not only horribly happy by nature, he can also tell you exactly how you could get to the old tower. I'd give Master Magician the message from me. If any more people here complain about his bizarre hocus pocus, I'll send a couple of bailiffs over to attend to him.
Of course. I'll let him know.
I have more important things to do.
That's all. I have no interest in speaking to him. My only interest is maybe drowning him in this river, but probably can't do that now. Hey, Beryl. I think we're okay to break these things in public. I don't recall people necessarily freaking out at you smashing barrels and stuff. Bunch of junk. All right. Fast travel portal harbor unlocked. Nice! So there is fast travel in this, huh? I have to figure out how that works. I'm sure it will explain it to me in time. I'm not really too worried. Alright, so we have the Leaping Stag Inn and the Sentry. So can I get the local map again? This is decidedly less helpful than I'd like. Part of me wishes that, like, one of the things I like in some games that they'll do is, you know, you get to a town, a place that is safe where you're generally not going to be attacked, and they just reveal the whole map so you can kind of have an idea where you're going. I understand that that doesn't necessarily make the most sense from, like, an in-character point of view, but it's just kind of a convenience feature that I have grown appreciative of in, I guess, recent years. Not that I'm gonna be like, oh, this game's terrible because it doesn't map all of the towns for me. It does look like there's maybe a path up here though, so I wanna check that out. I do remember there being reason to poke around in these games, like they'll hide little chests and stuff, and yeah, see, there's a chest right there, for example. They'll hide stuff in the background and stuff, which I love. Like, that is one of my favorite things in role-playing games, is being rewarded for, like, just poking around in the background and stuff. It doesn't even have to be anything interesting, like, you know, all right, we got a chest with some tinder fungus and some nails in it or whatever that was. I don't care about these things that I'm getting, but I'm just happy that it's like, hey, you know, I poked my head around this corner because I noticed that there's a little chunk of the map open right there. And, you know, it's a reward thing. You know, you like being rewarded for being nosy, I guess. And a lot of games really don't do that anymore. Like, the big one, man, this camera zoom, I wish, I'm gonna check the options really quick. Controls. Oh, anything for camera zoom? I have a feeling this is probably the spin, which I'm actually going to turn down. Because it's like ridiculous. Oh, that is so much better. But yeah, the zoom is still the zoom. I wish they kind of had maybe some more interim zoom, because this feels like it's too far out. The goats are doing goat noises, and there's a goat herder doing goat herder things. I'm gonna take this whirlweed. I'm gonna poke around. Like, I know what we have to do, but just because we have to do it doesn't mean that I can't, you know, get in trouble first. I wonder if there's gonna be an old lady screeching about wolves in this one. That is, they have it in like the first episode or two of the first game, and it is something that has just stuck with me. This old lady complaining about how the wolves or whatever were howling all the time. It's just great. It's like random stuff. Man, this game is nice looking. Like, these are some pretty good looking vistas. I'm impressed with it. Texture on that rock in particular is kind of muddy, but everything else looks really nice. Man, like, it makes me sad that these were basically kind of I don't want to say a one and done series, but they never really did anything else with it. I mean, there were the, what was it? There was, I think, an action RPG, like an MMO action RPG that they released based on this. I recall playing and it being kind of like, it was flash based or something, so it was crap, which makes me sad. All right, so we have a fast travel portal to the Mellow Ox, which is a tavern with a sparkly sign. Can I use the sign? No. Hello, chickens. I'm not gonna do anything here necessarily. But we can poke around a little bit. There's probably gonna be a fair amount of me just kind of randomly poking around. So does that mean, can I like just click on this to teleport to it? Is that how this works? No. I don't know. I mean, I could do the sensible thing and check the controls and see if there's like a fast travel button, which I'm not seeing. I don't know, like I said, I'm sure it's something that we will come into contact with. That's the downside to playing games like this digitally, is like the game, I think it comes with a manual on Steam. I think games on Steam come with manuals, I just don't know how to get to them. But with something like this, it's really helpful to have a manual on hand. So hey there, town guardsman, you're the guy I'm supposed to talk to.
Baron, what do you wish?
God, the voice acting. Harbor Master Orbert sends me. He said that you could tell me the way to the old watchtower.
Sure, but what do you want there? Don't you know that the tower is inhabited by an eccentric magician?
I'm aware of that. I was being sent there to complete my training.
I might have guessed that, actually, the way your cloak. Very well. I'll tell you how to get there. From here, you follow the path going east until you pass Boron's Field. From there, you follow the curved path going north, up the hill, and past Boron's Shrine. Once you've reached the top, keep left. There's a passage in the cliff that's easy to miss. That will take you directly to the old tower.
All right. And I will be on my way. Thank you for your help.
My pleasure. And good luck with your apprenticeship with that odd fellow. You'll need it.
Man. I appreciate the voice acting, don't get me wrong, but it's something that I can guarantee you guys I'm going to be making fun of this entire Let's Play. Sorry. like, I'm kind of the mind, like, with games like this, where they're very wordy, like, I like that it's voice acted. Like, for example, the Baldur's Gate games, Pillars of Eternity, I would love if those games were fully voice acted, but I totally understand why they're not. So this guy has a name, let's talk to him.
May Ifrit be with you. I can tell you about the Lord of the Tides, if you possess the necessary calm.
I'm not evil. sure, tell me about Ifrit.
From wind to storm, from ebb tide to high tide, that is the eternal cycle of the tides and of life itself. The god of water takes what he desires, but he can be pacified. Do you wish to know more?
Okay, here we go. Do you believe that there is a river father?
Maybe in the form of a talking fish, eh? That is just superstitious humbug. It is heresy. Ifrit alone has power over the river, and his waters and winds take many forms. Do you wish to know more?
What do you think of that Brother Emerin fellow?
Ah, the voice of the river father. Don't you find that simply absurd as well? Superstitious fear makes some illiterate fishermen and river travelers hail him as the envoy. Or maybe they feel sorry for him. Do you wish to know more?
Nope, that's it. Perhaps another time. Alright, so apparently there are different water gods here. Oh, let us poke around a little bit. Oh, what is this? Something possibly exploration worthy. Oh, there's barrels. This has been worth it already. And the reason that I'm kind of poking around... Alright. The reason that I'm kind of poking around is that in the first game, like, there are kind of NPCs and stuff floating around that'll join your party and stuff. Like, the... that Amazon you get in the very beginning. I can't remember her name. I remember Forgrim and I remember Gladys, but I do not remember the Amazon's name. She's just kind of like some random person that you can talk to at a tavern. Well, when you go up to the tavern, she's there bitching at a guy and you can tell him he's being a dick or whatever. What is this, like some illegal fight club you guys got going on back here? What is this?
You're lucky to run into me. No one knows as much about the arena fights as I do. So if you need an expert opinion, don't hesitate to ask me.
I'm good, not interested in shop talk. So wait. Okay, so this is just like, this isn't like they're pitting prisoners against each other, it's just an arena. Okay. Hey Beryl, how you doing? Some strong schnapps. Causes drunkenness. Nice. We're taking it. I really have no interest in arena combat being a wizard. I have a feeling it would probably not play to my strengths. So we are going to avoid that for the time being. However, I see some shoddy barrels. Man. Violence against the inanimate. Something that Devon is really good against. They can't fight back, so he can go all out. Okay. Well, the map ends here. Is this... Whoa, okay. Oh, they have submaps. Oh, that's actually really cool. I appreciate that greatly. Nice. Okay. Oh, this is actually a pretty large area. I was not expecting this. Well, to be fair though, the maps in the first one were pretty substantial too, so. Man, I just cannot get over how nice this game looks. One thing I do think, like, the bloom is a little much. There's, like, everything just has, like, this almost, like, unearthly glow to it, which is, I think, kind of the game's, just, like, how they wanted it to look. It doesn't look bad, but it's just very fascinating. So we do have a blacksmith. What? Oh. Alright, sure, I'm interested in your wares. Oh, I have so many things. And we have the currency. I totally forgot that, yeah, it was like gold, silver, and copper, ducats, thalers, and farthings. Let's go ahead and, oh my god, so many rusty nails and charcoal. I'm going to sell, for the time being, I'm going to be selling probably the grand majority of stuff that I pick up until I start needing it. I remember gold being something of a problem in the first game. Early on, I think later in we hit a point where it wasn't really too big an issue. No longer fresh. Okay, so what do we got here? An iron cap. So we could get this. Gives us some armor on our head. A sapper's apron, which is basically one armor across the board. Armor just... Wait a minute. Oh, they give us comparison. That is super handy. What else you got? Maybe a weapon. I would not mind, like, a sword. No. Alright. He's got some instructions if I wanted to make one, but I am not a smith. So I'm gonna accept this. And we are done here. A random townsperson. Anvil, Southgate fast travel. I do appreciate that there appear to be quite a number of fast travel points. Like, that is gonna be nice for navigating around in a town. I was gonna say, is that Forgrim? Do NPCs in this, like, actually have schedules where they kinda... Aw, man. If they actually... I'm digging this. Baron Dejean of Nadoret. Let's see, he's building a house, maybe. Let's pester him.
Hey, you, take a hike. Baron Dejean doesn't want to be pestered by riffraff during his visit to the town.
It's all right, Carsten, relax. I always have a sympathetic ear for my subjects. What's on your mind, my good man?
Oh, we have etiquette. It's most generous of your lordship to take a moment to speak with your most loyal vassal, Devon.
Very well. I see you're quite aware of your and my social class. I would like to reward you for the proof of your loyalty. Here, take this silver talor as a token of my generosity and tell me what you wish.
Do you know that pirates are marauding the lands hereabouts? My ship was attacked.
Pirates? Around here? How dreadful. You know, you should really hand in a petition to my servants in the castle. Then I'll deal with it right away. After the preparations for my next party are complete, of course. Now then, away with you. We would like to continue our stroll.
All right. Farewell, your lordship. We're not going to continue pestering him. I love how his other guards just like, yeah, I'm leaving you, screw it. Oh, that's kind of cool. I dig it that they're kind of letting you throw in the social skills. That was something that I recall actually being fairly useful in the first game as well, which is why, you know, I wasn't really whinging about investing in etiquette and stuff when we were creating the character initially, because, you know, every little bit. We got some wealthy townsfolk here that I don't think we can pickpocket or anything. Okay, so with that, I think we're done poking around in town, so we can go ahead and get out. I don't think we missed a little area over here. Can I get this note off of here now? Ah. I see that there is an exclamation point for secrets, and we actually did miss a quest at the Leaping Stag, so we'll go back and deal with that. That's, I think, us listening to things, if I recall correctly. No, I don't want you on aggressive. I want you on not passive either. All right, passive it is, I guess. Quest book. Is this one. Yes. I'm to report back to Ardo, the Traveler's leader at the Leaping Stag. So we'll go do that. See here, it looks like I'm just gonna kind of follow the road around here. Man. This game. I think I'm just really like... I'm really hard up for something like the old Neverwinter Nights, and like, if this game came with a tool set, oh my god. I would have dove so deep into that, I don't know. I would have fussed with that a lot. Wait a minute, what was that? Oh, so can I like... Alright, so that's how the fast travel works. You just have to be on one of the locations, and then you can click on it and it takes you, okay. That's fair. Excuse me. I've run out of water. I'm in the spat of recording a bunch of other stuff, and I'm out of water, and I just killed off my coffee while we were listening to St. Joulbert back there going on about pirates and the lack of his, you know, ability to deal with them until after his party. He looks like he likes parties. I'm just saying. Okay, so, random drunk. Where did that inn disappear to again? I can't see you. Sorry, buddy. I think you maybe Need to step it down a little. You know, kick it off a few notches. Okay. So we are in the inn. There's Ardo. Let's see, is there anybody else floating around? Joke. Oh, God. I must know. Old woman! I can't talk to you. Ah. I was hopeful. All right. How bad is a joke teller and a joke cracker? Let's hear it. Leave me be. Oh, seriously? You guys, I'm so disappointed. Ponderer, a philosopher, and a worrywart. Barmaid Dorgrasha. We're not gonna harass her, she's a barmaid. I have a feeling she's not gonna join our party. I'm looking for party members. That's why I'm kinda, you know, skeeving around and stuff. Hey there, Ardo.
Ah, there you are. Did you find out anything useful?
Not yet. I'll keep my ear to the ground, though. See you soon. All right. So we can't actually. We haven't apparently flipped the switches that will, you know, give us some information. Because yeah, it's fair. We haven't really heard anything. I figure we're probably supposed to go and do our training, and then, you know, at some point during that we'll hear. Oh hey, you know. It turns out that Ardo is the Dark Lord, and he has a ring, and, you know, Voldemort is coming back for it, and Gandalf has to fight Dumbledore. Who knows? These things are confusing. All right, so we have a bowyer, we have a healer. Actually, we want to talk to you.
What brings you to me?
I want to see what kind of medicine you have. Wound. Oh man, that stuff is expensive. Man, this is all expensive. I remember Golmoon tea being quite useful. Yeah, it's poison. All right. Alright, so this will give us a regeneration effect for 10 minutes. Regenerates our vitality points by 1. And bandages are just used for stitching yourself up after having been maimed by pretty much everything in the world. Laboratory. Workbench. Alright. Let's see here. See that, I think. Where's this? No, wrong button. What did I even hit to do that? Q, no. Tab, no. I didn't hit escape, I don't know. Maybe I did hit escape. I don't know, you guys. Alright, I think, yeah, this is just leaning back down to the fight club. Alright, fair enough. Oh, that's right, yeah, the Temple of Prios, okay. Yeah, it's set on the map for that area that the secondary, or tertiary, I guess, exit was. It said, I read Temple, and so I guess that was the Temple of Prios. So we have Crooked Otto here.
Well, are you looking for that certain something? Then you're at the right place here.
All right. What is this? All right, so he's got monster bits, apparently. Which this is crafting stuff, like, without a doubt. Get rid of these goose feathers. Oh, we're done. Don't need anything else from you, my friend. I just need to get out of town. This is a, oh hey, it's the Baron again. Just like run up next to him and shiv him really quick. This would be like me playing the new Hitman game, you know, I just run past, shoot him in the head, and then just keep going. And then by the time everybody's realized, oh hey, he's dead, I'm gone. All right, take me to the Mellow Ark. Well, I don't know which is gonna be closer. Let's go to the Mellow Ark. Now I have to, I assume, let's see here. Towers up in this direction. So I guess we'll go this way. I know the guy gave me directions, but I like kind of, you know, poking around and doing things my own way, which often tends to lead to me getting into horrible, horrible situations that I ought not be in, but hey, that's why you guys tune in, right? So let's see what we have up here. Oh my god, little goats. And those are some derpy looking goats, but okay. All right, oh, we have the local graveyard. Okay, so this is probably not what we're looking for. Let's see, what do we have on our map? Something Roaring Field, I don't know. It's probably the name of the graveyard if I had to guess. So let's come back this way and we'll follow the riverbank up here and see where that goes. Cause I'm not exactly in a hurry to get through this game. I wanna kinda, you know, just go at my own pace. Poke around, get killed by everything. Hello, hollow tree stump. Okay, I'm gonna store some elm wood in my tree stump here. We have fast travel. Oh, let's... No. All right, so we can't leave yet, apparently, which makes sense. Traveling mercenary. Yeah, this is this looks like the end from the first game. That's great. And this even looks kind of like the innkeeper.
Welcome to the Mellow Ox. How may I help you?
I'd like something to drink. Can you show me what you have? Ferdok Pale Ale and the Nadoret Double Bock. Baron Dajan of Nadoret has had this beer brewed as a response to the famous Ferdok Pale Ale from the country's capital. The competitor product, however, failed due to its abominable taste. It's just purely terrible. Whereas the Pale Ale at least causes drunkenness and gives you some stat boosts along with it. Ridiculous. That is the Drakensang games. I do appreciate that these games kind of have a little bit of a sense of humor to them. A lot of RPGs tend to take themselves way too seriously. And, you know, levity can be a good thing. Alright, so since that way's blocked, look around here. We got some piggies. Alright, a poisoned girl. Person in mourning. Well, you'd sit there and be poisoned, because I figure if I talk to you, it might start a time limit or something. And should I remember, I'll bring you something to fix that. I probably won't remember. Well, here, we're in the Mellow Ox. Take me back. Oh, I think it was at the marketplace. Man, we're gonna have to... Nah, let's continue. I don't even know why that popped up. Weird. I don't even know, we could do that, like, the next time I'm in town, we'll, assuming I remember, we'll do that, but I don't necessarily want to blow too much time just kind of randomly doing a lot of, you know, back and forth stuff. Little Aunt Balmar. What's going on here? Villagers sitting around. We got a path going off that way. You got that. Random little church, it looks like. Alright, we have a I think maybe up here? Let's find out. Well, it looks like there's certainly a path. That counts for something. You know, we've won half the battle already. Naturally, I'm supposed to go that way, but I'm not going to. Oh, hey. Convenient. Hello, Oneberries. Can I get you? Ow. I remember Oneberries being incredibly handy in the first game. I don't remember why. But I'll take some of them if I can get my hands on them. I think it might be, like, healing or something. I don't know. We've entered the area where the bloom dares not reside. Alright, well, we are at 29 minutes, so you guys know I love ending on a cliffhanger, so we are gonna call it. And I will catch you all next time where the adventure continues and we kinda go into the Magician's Tower. Until then, take it easy.